These are passing stuff, you know. Don't waste your time with it.
It's like coronavirus is here and it will go away someday.
Yes. Exactly. And I tell you, if you don't watch the news a lot, you will automatically have this tiksha. Koi problem hi nahi hogi, because you will not know all the small details of curve aise upar jaan upar niche. If you start listening to news, tumhara man bhi upar niche jata hai. But if you take that, you know, ki theek hai, 100 saal pehle hua tha, 3 saal mein chala gaya, 2 saal mein chala gaya, ye bhi chala jayega. Just endure it, that's all.
Or you have to remember who you really are.
Yeah, if you can do that, baki sab gir jayega waise. True. If you can make that high jump, then all these 6 things will automatically be in your pocket. Right? You will not be struggling with one little thing. Okay, so we're going a little bit over, but it's okay, we can finish this. It is okay, only a little bit, huh?
Quickly do it. Mm-hmm. Shraddha, is the healthy attempt at a clear intellectual appreciation of the exact import of the pregnant words of the scriptures, as well as advice of the preceptor, guru, that is a teacher?
Basically, we all know what Shraddha is by now. It's a deep understanding that, you know, there is something higher.
Samadhana.
समाधान हिंदी में बोलते हैं ना, एक वर्ड है ना, सभी को आता होगा कि ये समाधान हो गया मुझे. दैट्स व्हाट इट मींस, सेटिस्फैक्शन जिसको बोलते हैं.
इज द स्टेट ऑफ पॉइस एंड ट्रैंक्विलिटी, दैट इज द सिंगल पॉइंटेडनेस ऑफ द माइंड गेन्ड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ कांस्टेंट कंटेंप्लेशन ऑन द सुप्रीम एंड द डिवाइन.
सो जब ट्रैंक्विलिटी होती है तभी हम लोग एंगेज करेंगे वो हायर में, यू नो.
एंड Mumukshutva is the impatient and a burning desire for liberation, that is to realize the self within, which is the self in all.
One last little paragraph is there. You have it or you don't?
I don't have anything more than that.
Okay, in mine it just says verse 20 to 29, with the third boon he wants to know the meaning of the great passing beyond. That's the word in quotation he put. Lord Death tests Nachiketa. The seeker insists to know and reject all other substitute gifts. So just summarizing the thing. So this ends this section over here. Anybody has any question on this short, I mean, this 4 things required pre-qualification?
I have one question.
Huh?
On this Sat Sampatti. Mm. 6 ethical perfections. Mm. Is there any order to this, or they just go simultaneously?
You know, I think one thing I have seen in Vedanta, they don't jo order karte na, usme hai connection. Aap socho to hoega definitely. Because shuru kara unhone shama se, right? Man ko thoda sa peaceful banao pehlo, then you will be able to do the dama. Fir uparati tum kar paoge. फिर तितिक्षा अपने आप हो जाएगी, फिर श्रद्धा आएगी, और फिर समाधान. अगर तुमको ये 5 चीजें मिल गई तो समाधान अपने आप मिल जाएगा. ट्रू, दे आर वेरी वेरी गुड एट लाइक, उनका मतलब क्या बोलते हैं, सीक्वेंस है ना, उसमें भी मीनिंग है. एंड दैट्स व्हाई दैट वो जो 8 लिम्स ऑफ योगा में भी एग्जैक्टली वही है. यम और नियम, यम है सबसे पहले, which is, you know, all different. Next is niyam. Yam is control of senses. Niyam is, you know, when you make niyam in your like daily habits, tum banate ho. And uske baad phir wo asan, and asan ke baad pranayam. So koi pehle bola main baith hi nahi paun seedha aur main pranayam shuru kar diya. They said no, that's not possible. First learn to sit down quietly. You know, so it has a sequence. Any other question on this? No? Okay. So I'm going to close the class here. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhatrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukha Bhag Bhavet, Hari Om Shri Guru Pyo Namaha, Hari Om. Both of them. So any, since it was so heavy duty, any kind of question on those, whatever we did today, we'll give that a priority.
But I have a statement. There was something very simple that you said, that when we go to drop somebody off at the airport, we already come back and say, wo India chala gaya, wo LA chala gaya. That actually opened a lot of cobwebs for me in my mind. It's a very simple thing, but it made me understand a couple of things very clearly.
Good.
That I had not thought about. I associated that thing to what I'm feeling.
So I'm happy, because that's what happens, that I also learn better with examples. And that's why I try to think, you know. So yesterday when I was reading and, you know, preparing for the class, I said, you know, how do I explain this? And then so I thought of this, because everybody has experienced that, you know. And then Swamiji gives a similar example about when you want to have tea, then you say, main chai bana rahi hun. And when you're just putting the water, chai bani nahi abhi tak. But you already assume that if I'm going to put the chai patti, I already know the sequence and I'm going to do it and it's going to happen. So what here is saying?
For me, the association meant that I'm already on this plane of Gita class. Kabhi na kahi pahunchenge.
That's what they mean. That's exactly what they mean. Yes. If you keep at it. It's like if I want to travel from here to New York and I sit in my car, if I'm on the correct road, I will reach. There might be storm on the way. Then my tire might become flat. Sab kuch hoega. You know, if you're taking a long journey for a week, yahan ki to gaadiyan bahut achhi hoti. India mein to, I remember when my dad used to take us on a road trip, it was understood. Do teen baar to kuch gadbad hone wala rehta. But hum log end mein pahunch hi jaate the. That's exactly what it is. So I'm glad, Neelu ji, that you used to see it at that within.
The reason I find discussion very useful is also because after going through the class, like just now, Neelu came up and she re-emphasized the example that Umaji gave. So it's made me start thinking about that example all over again. It did make a lot of sense when you were talking about it, but now that she said it, then it is embedded in the brain a little more. And I think I will ponder about it and I think learn a lot more. And that's why I think the discussion of how each one of us perceives something is so important.
Yeah.
To, at least to me, I find that very useful. Yeah.
True. Did anybody read that verse about verse 29?
No, instead of going further, can we go again on all those six qualities? Can we go more deeper about them?
Okay. I mean, we can do that. So basically, there are four division. First, beginning mein, Vivek, Vairagya, Shat Sampatti, or Mumukshutvam. Right? So Vivek or Vairagya, to abhi sabko achhe se malum pad gaya, right?
Uh-huh.
Is there anything you want to discuss on Vivek and Vairagya?
No, I think they are very clear.
Yeah. Shat Sampatti mein unhone 6 bataye hain. Shama, Dama, Uprati, Titiksha, Shraddha and Samadhan. Shama is, yahan par bataya, peaceful state of mind. Shanti se Shama aya hai. Wo same hi, uska root word kuch same hi hai. Mere ko bahut deep nahi maalum hai Sanskrit, but basically that's what I was told ki शांति वाला ही ये क्षमा है. तो जब मैं शांति करती हूँ मन में, तो वो उसको क्षमा बोलते हैं. दमा है मैं सेंस कंट्रोल, जो मेरी पांच ज्ञानेंद्रिया, पांच कर्मेंद्रियां है ना, मेरे सुनना, देखना, सूंघना, ये सब उसको मैं अपने वश में रखती हूँ. दैट बिकम दमा. उपरति सेल्फ विड्रॉवल फ्रॉम थिंग्स दैट आर नॉट कंड्यूसिव टू मी. उपरति उसका, सिंस कमला जी इज आस्किंग, ऊपर मींस ऊपर उठ जाना, रति मींस टू रेवल इन इट. आई एम डांसिंग टू अनदर ट्यून, बोल दो, इंग्लिश में बोलते हैं ना. लाइक व्हाट स्वामी जी वाज सेइंग इज, यू नो, वंस यू काइंड ऑफ इस सब्जेक्ट में इंटरेस्ट आने लगता है ना जब, तो दूसरी कोई कोई चीजें बहुत फालतू लगती है सुनने में. you know, all of a sudden you don't feel like going to certain parties and all that. Forget about even the higher Brahma Gyan and all ki baate. But there are people who are interested in poetry and they are interested in philosophy. Where if they sit in a group where the people are only talking about, you know, buying cars and jewelry and bigger house and all, they're not going to like it. तो वो उपरति हो गई उनको उससे. That's called उपरति, you know. And titiksha is endurance of small things in life. You let go instead of complaining. At a body level, you know, बहुत गर्मी है, बहुत सर्दी है, you know. There are people on this beach that I go to, it is like 50 degrees and they are running in a t-shirt. I said, my God, these guys are like, you know, unko titiksha bolo, unko hai bodily level pe to. I don't know, aage ho. I'm wearing a coat and mereko lagta hai muffler bhi laga do aur ye log aise, you know, shorts mein bhag rahe hai with no top. Titiksha. Shraddha. Shraddha, Kamla ji, you very well know what Shraddha is, right? So that's the fifth one. And Samadhan. वो भी एक बहुत हिंदी का बहुत अच्छा वर्ड है. मुझे इसमें समाधान है, संतुष्टि है. आई डोंट वॉन्ट एनीथिंग मोर, यू नो, जो भी मुझे भगवान ने दिया है आई एम टोटली फाइन विद इट. देन यू गेट दैट ट्रैंक्विलिटी एंड योर माइंड गेट एब्जॉर्ब्ड इन द हायर. दैट्स व्हाट इट इज. एंड द मुमुक्षुत्वम वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट इट. मैंने बोला ना, आप बोलते हो ना कि मुझे अभी चाहिए ब्रह्म ज्ञान, वो है मुमुक्षुत्व.
I think samadhan means solution. That can be
one meaning of it. Over here, samadhan has more to do with feeling tranquil. Because that, जैसे कि एक एक word को दो meaning में use किया जा सकता है. जो आप जो बोल रहे हो वो भी सही है कि उस चीज का समाधान क्या है. पर आप philosophically speaking ना, मीरा जी, समाधान कब होएगा? जब मन शांत, सब कुछ मेरे को मालूम पड़ गया है तो मेरा मन वैसे ही शांत हो जाएगा ना. थिंक अबाउट इट फिलोसफिकली स्पीकिंग.
अनदर मीनिंग कुड बी कि ये पांच चीजें अगर आपने कंट्रोल अपने काबू में कर ली हैं तो वो समाधान हो गया.
हाँ हाँ, वो भी
टू द लास्ट स्टेप.
ट्रू दैट वी डिस्कस दैट विद व्हेन I think Anil ji was asking that question or somebody asked. Huh? Mm-hmm.
And when you were going through the steps also that this leads to this and this and this and this. So finally all of that will lead you to the ultimate solution.
True. Your line of thinking is correct.
Are we agreeing that Samadhan also means solution?
There is one meaning of that solution, but philosophically speaking, agar aap koi cheez mein bahut disturbed ho, Neelu ji, samjho. और आपको उसका सोल्यूशन मिल गया तो आपके मन पे क्या असर होगा? आप शांत हो जाओगे ना.
शांति
हो, तो समाधान हो गया. तो ये माइंड लेवल पे शांति. सो दैट मीनिंग फिट्स परफेक्टली वेल देयर.
यू कैन आल्सो कैन इट आल्सो बी दैट ऑल योर क्वेश्चंस हैव बीन आंसर्ड.
यस, आई वाज गोइंग टू से दैट यू आर राइट अनिल जी. बिकॉज जो हम लोग के डाउट्स होते हैं, जैसे आप देखोगे जब हम लोग भगवद गीता की जर्नी हम लोग ने शुरू की है, चैप्टर 18 में अर्जुन इज गोइंग टू टेल कृष्ण भगवान कि नाउ ऑल माय क्वेश्चंस आर आंसर्ड एंड आई एम फीलिंग वेरी पीसफुल एंड आई एम रेडी टू डू व्हाट यू टोल्ड मी टू डू. यू नो, नष्टो मोहा, दैट्स हाउ इट स्टार्ट्स. दैट मेरा मोह नष्ट हो गया. यू नो, स्मृति लब्ध्वा, आई रिमेंबर्ड एवरीथिंग नाउ हु आई एम. सो उसको समाधान हो गया वो टाइम. पर उसने पहले कितने प्रश्न पूछे थे, देखा ना. कब होगी आपको लिबरेशन की? तभी होगी ना जब आपका मन शांत होगा और उसमें लगेगा. और ये आपको मतलब मुमुक्षुत्वम एक्चुअली इज कनेक्टेड विद ईच वन ऑफ देम. आपका मुमुक्षुत्वम बढ़ता जाएगा जैसे जैसे आप षट संपत्ति, विवेक, वैराग्य सब आएगा, उत्तम मुमुक्षुत्वम ऑटोमेटिकली बढ़ेगा आपका. बिकॉज अगर इट इज समथिंग लाइक दिस, सपोज आई एम इन अ ड्रीम एंड वंस आई नो विद इन द ड्रीम दैट इट इज अ ड्रीम, मेरे को उठने की कितनी जल्दी होएगी फिर. यू नो, आई डोंट वॉन्ट ऑल दिस फॉल्स, आई वॉन्ट द रियल वर्ल्ड. यू नो, आई डोंट वॉन्ट दिस. That's what it is, Mumukshutva. Ki mujhe pata chal gaya abhi.
But to me, it was always like that, Umaji. That would be the first thing to me, you know. I know as increases as we go along, but the desire, the keen desire to know, like, you know, that is the first thing that will start me to do all these things because I want to be there.
See, in the beginning, the desire is not very keen.
No.
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 Okay.
Okay, let Kamala ji say what she wants to say.
Here, actually, we are trying to come at Samatva Buddhi through all these 6 steps. And then that longing, that desire, the extreme desire develops because all those doubts are gone. We are above those levels which are disturbing us, you know, with all these 6 things. I think we have more control over our senses. We understood things. We are more samatva buddhi now. And now our focus is just on that goal, and that desire has intensified now.
It's just the intensity of desire. That's where I think what Meena ji is saying, in some aspect, you are right. In the beginning, we do have the desire. What you are saying is, when I develop a little bit of that desire, that's where I'm going to work. That's what you are saying, right, Meena ji?
Yeah. There has to be something, and that has to
so you, what you are right, but read over here. Mumukshutva means impatient and intense, burning desire. That's the only difference. So what Kamala ji is saying is true also. Shuru mein thodi desire, bina thodi desire ke to koi karega bhi nahi. Right? Why would anybody go on this path? Main party karun, main ye karun, mereko itna maza aa raha hai. Why would I sit and sing some satsang or something?
Definitely, it'll increase.
Yeah. But as I go in the satsang, it will lead me to mumukshutva. Because I'm, you know, it's like a, kya bolna chahiye? Jaise in Sanskrit mein na ek word hai, gati. Sabhi ne suna hai ki gati means, right?
Gati mil gayi.
Gati ka meaning, double meaning hai Sanskrit mein. Ek hai गोल, उसको भी गति बोलते हैं, और एक है पाथ, उसको भी गति बोलते हैं.
मोक्ष को भी गति कहते
हैं. Yes, you are absolutely right. But गति is also speed, means मैं उसकी तरफ बढ़ रही हूँ. And it's the same exact concept what you were talking about, Neelu ji, that, you know, I'm going to India, that person is going to India, and I say, वो इंडिया चला गया, वो गया, पहुंचा नहीं है, but he's on the right path. So once you have a little bit of desire, and if these 6 things come to you or other 3 things come, mumukshutvam will automatically happen then. Intensify hoti jayegi wo desire.
Like main itni baar class mein discuss karti hu ki mujhe badi ichha hai, bahut desire hai ki main, par abhi wo pure 6 steps nahi cover kar payi hu main, to mumukshutvam tak abhi tak nahi pahunchi hu. Jab ye sab पहुंच के हम मुमुक्षुत्वम तक पहुंचेंगे, तब है वो इंटेंसिफाइड डिजायर, देन वी आर वेरी क्लोज टू आवर गोल.
सो आई विल टेल यू अ दृष्टांत ऑफ मुमुक्षुत्वम व्हिच आई एम श्योर वंस आई टेल यू यू हैव हर्ड दिस स्टोरी बिफोर, एंड आई नो मीना जी हैज डेफिनेटली हर्ड इट. एंड द मुमुक्षुत्व का स्टोरी है कि दिस पर्सन केम एंड सेड, जैसे यहां से डिस्कशन हो रहा था कि व्हाट इज मुमुक्षुत्वम एंड ऑल दैट, सो वो दिस पर्सन वाज द रिवर बैंक. And I think it was Vivekananji the, or किसी ने Vivekananji का नाम लिया, कोई भी स्वामी हो सकता है. उसका चेला आया, बोला ये मुमुक्षुत्वम क्या होता है, तो वो Vivekananji ने उसको ना ऐसे पकड़ के ना पानी के नीचे पकड़ लिया उसका सर, और वो छटपटाए और यू नो लाइक ही, एंड देन ही केम आउट आफ्टर सम यू नो फ्यू मिनट्स ही रिलीज्ड हिम. And this was like, this chela said, what are you trying to do? Are you trying to kill me or what? So he said, no, tell me one thing. When I was pushed you under the water, what were you thinking? Were you thinking of your wife? He said, no. Were you thinking of your money? No. Were you thinking of nothing? What were you thinking? He said, I was thinking of, I want to breathe. I want air. So he said, mumukshutvam is when you have that kind of desire for God.
Yes.
That's called mumukshutvam, he said. So when they're talking about mumukshutvam, that stage, like Buddha, like when he was like 30, whatever, two, how old was he when he left his home? 28, I'm not sure. Maybe you guys know. When he left, mumukshutvam hoga tha usko wo time pe.
Yes.
when he left the entire kingdom, his wife, his child, and he just left, you know. I want to know, and I'm not coming back until I know it. That's mumukshutvam. It's like when we hear Swamiji's story, apne Chinmayananji's, if whoever saw the movie, you know, once he made a decision after he went to Shivanand's place and he took the sannyas and he wanted to study, then unki pariksha bhi li gayi thi. Wo pura hike karke unko bheja. And when he reached to his second guru, Tapovan Maharaj, and Tapovan Maharaj said, did you bring a letter? And he said, no, I did not. He said, go back. And he was like, oh my God, it took me 4 days sleeping under the tree, because he was testing him. So he didn't argue, he didn't complain. He came down, he brought the letter, and it seems that second time when he took the letter, Tapovan Maharaj didn't even look at the letter. He said, okay, you're ready, you're my student now. Because he didn't complain, went back and came. You know? That was mumukshutvam for him. And then I also heard that he, for 7 years, he had to go bring the Ganga water every morning. And it was a huge hike just to bring water for their survival. And he did that. And here he was from a rich family. He was educated, he had a great job, everything was there, but he just had a mumukshutvam. He said, this is what I want, and I don't want anything else.
Yeah, when the goal becomes single pointed,
yeah,
when you break all other ties.
But the good news in Bhagavad Gita is that according to Krishna Bhagwan, you can reach there wherever you are. You don't need to go to the jungle. You don't need to go to the gufa. You don't need to do anything, you know. You develop this and everything will come to you.
Yeah, but you need to develop all this.
I mean, they are laid down the path. I mean, you know, so we cannot say we don't know now, you know. We cannot say that anymore. But, we have just a couple minutes. Since you had asked that, you know, who God is, it's a very long journey, and that is the subject anyway. So eventually we are definitely going to reach there. But whatever we have studied so far, just to revise it, you know, who God is. So everybody's heard of Sat Chit Anand, right? So that's one definition of God. Is Sat Chit Anand, conscious, you know, all bliss and truth, you know. And then there is another one. I don't know exactly what it is. Is it Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma? I think that's what it is. Satyam Jnanam. Satyam is truth. Jnanam is knowledge. Anantam is infinite. Brahma is this one big reality. That's another definition. And then all religion, they have these three things they always talk about. Omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient. So omnipresent means present everywhere. Omnipotent means all-powerful. Omniscient means all-knowing. That's third definition of God. And then in chapter 2, they have given some terms. Sanskrit mein, Kamlaji, you will connect to this word. Nitya means eternal. Sarvagataha means all-pervading. Avyaktaha means unmanifested. Achintya is unthinkable. Avikarya, unchangeable. Jisme koi vikar nahi hota. It's avikarya. Sthanuhu is stable. Achala is immovable. Sanatana is forever, like ancient. And this is from verse 24 and 25 of chapter 2, which we have already done.
No, we know all these qualities, but what it is?
Agar aap is pe chintan nahi karoge, isko nahi samjhoge, to fir God ko bhi nahi samajh paoge. Isi pe to chintan karna hai.
Main aaya ki wo sab jagah hai, har kan kan mein samaya hua hai, wo...
Kamla, tell us what you understand by God. What is God?
I'm still searching for it. Is it energy? Is it vibrations?
No.
Is it? I'm still searching for it. What is it? There is some. This is some power which is controlling this whole universe, which is creating, maintaining it, destroying it, performing all these functions. But what is that power?
This is what you have to do, Kamlaji. Whatever ideas we have, just drop all of them first. Because if you keep going back to energy, then you will be stuck at it. So start fresh in your mind. Okay, Joe, go ahead.
How can you search for it? Is your mind searching for it? Is your brain? Or you yourself are searching? Who are you?
Good question. Very good.
The one I sent you, the one on rum. What was that? The one Sir Priyanand talk one. He explains exactly what you are asking.
Okay, can you explain me in very simple words what is God?
Simple is that you are, the God is one which is all over the universe, including in you. And then
I fully understand.
And that you is covered by your body. And your mind, which is very limited, because you are under the time dimension.
No, but what is it? What is it?
You cannot grasp it by your five senses. There's another thing, Joe, that you should emphasize, because that's what I think Kamalaji's trying to do. And the reason I gave you this definition, it says unthinkable. You know?
No,
ungraspable. How you can do it then with your five senses?
Even Krishna said all these things. He said, I am, but he said, this is only a part of me, so I'm beyond that. So that's why, and even to see that portion, he has to give him special eyes to Arjun. So it's not comprehensible by a human being.
True.
And actually, you won't exist when you meet God.
So This is what. So we have to meet him to know him.
Yes. You have to become it to know it. That's all. You have to become it. It's like a drop going in the ocean. You know, it feels separate, but the moment it merges, it has become the ocean.
Gita, that's what you understand.
Kamala, don't put me in this situation.
No. That's okay. This is not because we know that we are all searching for it and we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing like a situation or anything, because all of us who are sitting here, we know that God, but when it comes to really to define it, we know all the definitions, that it's all pervading, it's all omniscient, omnipotent.
No, but wait a minute, Kamalaji, you keep saying you know. But we don't know. We think we know, we don't.
Yeah.
So to answer Kamala's question, my personal approach is that I don't think too much about it, because I have all these, the same questions that all of you are asking in my mind, also without answers. So I really concentrate on the main issues which are going to help me in this life and contained in the Gita, which is the non-attachment. You know, I really try to concentrate on improving my own life by trying to become non-attached, so that I don't suffer from the highs and the lows, the joys and the sorrows and the all of that. I keep reminding myself of that, and I remind myself of always keeping my motives pure, trying to make my actions the kind where I'm not putting myself first, and trying to make sure that my actions don't harm another person, purposely. Also, at the same time, and as Bhagwan tells us to keep keep fighting for the truth. So sometimes, I feel that I need to fight against misinformation in this age, because that is harming the world. And so I speak up when I hear misinformation. That makes me very unpopular, but I think that I'm doing my duty. And so I am that is the essence of how I'm living my life.
So these,
I
this,
don't think
this
about God like, so much, because I know, okay, I would not understand it with my five senses, as you're saying.
So these looks like the golden rules to make this life worth living, without any conflicts with people, with peace and
right.
So I understand that this is the ideal way to live life, so that we have minimum conflicts with the world around us and within ourselves. But yes. And after doing all that, I understand one more step, like, okay, If you lift up your energy, you feel peace, and we are looking for that peace and joy. So that peace and joy is God. But actually what it is,
I think Sushilji has something to say. Let Sushilji say. Go ahead, Sushil.
So what I'm going to say was, for any of us or for you, if we are looking for God in a physical form, you are never going to see him.
No, not in the physical form.
Let him finish, yeah.
Okay, that's one. The other one, if you really want to understand, and after all these things have not been able to understand, then it says you can define, you can go with what God is not. I mean, that's what they call about niyati and niyati. God is not this.
Oh, neti, you mean.
Neti,
yeah.
So that's the other way to understand, because you're never going to see him in physical form. I mean, this is, it comes up in, I think, in Gita somewhere also, that you, only thing you can do is by understanding what, away from the physical form.
True.
If that's the only way to understand, there's nobody can define it in any other way. It has been defined number of ways, and if that's not clear, then go by neti, what you said.
Neti. All are very good points, all of you.
Yeah, okay.
Point. Yes. I think that what Gita ji said was very good, and what Sushil ji said also. All these things help in our journey.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Now, thank you so much. It was a good discussion.
Thank you so much.
And see you next time.
Now, just in closing, I did want to say that I thought, Gita, what you said was very valuable, in the sense that, you know, in very quick and easy steps, you outlined exactly what we are capable of doing. At least I can talk for myself at this stage, you know. I'm not like the others who are, you know, intellectually, I think, or spiritually at a more advanced place. So I just was able to connect so well with everything you said. And I said, if we can just do that, it's a very good beginning, I think.
Yes, I agree. I agree, because the path is very, and it is laid out in Bhagavad Gita. Whenever he's talking about all these things, that's what it is. Okay, you know the knowledge, but how to reach there, you follow this. And whatever Gita ji said, it's like part of Karma Yoga. So that's all we can do. That's all in our hand. Baki, you know, we have to just let go. Then only we will experience it. Otherwise, we will be constantly in this struggle. So everybody's point was very valid. So with that, I'm sorry we didn't do the birthday thing, but still best wishes for all of you, birthday girls and boys. And we'll see you next time.